It is Sunday, August 20th, 2017. The video you are about to see was recorded in May of 2016, and it has to do with Whitey's water pump and Tony rebuilding it. And there won't be any comments at the end of this, and this is part one, and there might not be a part two, because part of the reason there's been so long since the last video is because this machine just continually degrades. So yes, I know there's glitches in the video, there might be glitches in the audio. I have done everything I've known that I know how to do. I have swapped out the motherboard, I have swapped out the RAM, it passes MEM test. I was told I should get an SSD hard drive, so I did. And things may work good for a while, but then it slowly degrades and it's like it loses its memory. So you do something for a while in the editing program, then when you close it and you come back, well, it forgot things. Sometimes it'll forget things you do and you edit everything. If you don't close it out and then open it back up and then render it, then it'll forget things. So I haven't blue screened in a long time, but then I haven't crashed the program. It's just, it doesn't want to function. And it's been this way with this machine, like, from the beginning. So, you might have to wait till part two comes out. And until then, I guess I'll just keep fighting this thing. I've even gone back. I'm using Corel Video Studio 8. I have 9. And I tried 10. And I even went back to 6. And it's not making any difference. So, you get what you get, because that's all I can do. So, away we go. I'm Jeff Bradshaw with Redneck Restorations. This old truck brought to you by ElderlyIron.com. Well, it's time to go see Professor Grumpy here. There's an exceptionally grumpy mood today. Tony, this is Project Whitey's water pump. Ready?
I'm ready.
Go.
Okay, guys. So here we have a 56-59 pony water pump. We're going to try to show you how to take it, disassemble it the best way without breaking. So hang in there and we'll do the best we can. So also I would like to mention that tools and equipment I have, I'm sure you don't have it at home. So you would have to improvise and do it in a way that is the best way to do it without breaking it.
Usually a torch and a hammer.
That's a good way to start. That way you don't have to rebuild it.
200 Davis Creek Road, Selma, Oregon.
So, as you notice, we take the hot butts first, which is 99.9% of the time has to be done first before you can do anything else. There are exceptions, but you'll run into it when you get there.
So how do you know how far back down it has to go?
I boo-booed. But we're lucky we have another one.
Great.
I forgot to measure. Going ahead of myself. 8 millimeter. I like to measure metric because it's easier.
That's because he's an import.
Yeah, that too. Now, we set the pump on a tube to where the bearing can slide into. Because if not, you'll break it.
I should have said alien. He's an alien.
Illegal too. But I forgot something. So first, before you do anything, put your pump on the bearing on something solid. Put a tubing or whatever over the on the impeller and break the impeller loose first.
Did you hear all that? Break the impeller loose first.
Okay.
Let's step up in our technology.
Test. How's it work?
How's it work?
Yeah.
You talk and it picks you up.
Okay. Yeah, just what I need.
Audio. Okay. Audio will be greatly improved from this point forward.
So we broke loose the impeller because now we have to push the bearing through the housing, and this is not the strongest impeller, so we don't want to break it. If we break it, we're in deep doo-doo.
Except for this other pump that showed up on his doorstep that we don't know where it came from.
Oh-ho! Bingo! We didn't break it.
Crispy, crunchy. That might have leaked.
Ah, put some silicone on it. That'll work. Are.
Little JB Weld.
That too. Okay. So now, question. Do we want to bead blast this?
Yeah.
Well, then you better put the blaster back together so we can use it.
Back together. Mm-hmm. It's apart.
You got to put the hose together and tape up that hole.
We'll knock the seal out of it.
That's the next thing we're going to do.
I can take it. I mean, I can't blast it after you put it back together. Well, I could, but... It's just that easy.
So here, we have an empty housing. Didn't break. Hallelujah.
The blast cabinet. Made by tall people. For tall people. What kind of tape am I going to use to tape the hole?
Coming up.
What?
Move. Please. Because you're doing it wrong.
That's the very same thing I was going to do.
When?
When you said I was doing it wrong.
Hey, catch.
I'd like it, huh? Yes, we are using electrical tape to cover a hole in a 120, 140 PSI blast nozzle.
That's enough.
It is?
Yeah.
It's only 3 wraps.
All right.
There. Happy?
No.
I didn't think so.
Because now...
All better?
All better. Now we can go to work. So here we have a classic example of where the original seal wore into the impeller. From past experience, you can machine this and polish it until you're blue in the face, and the new seal will not last. I use an old shaft out of a bearing, press it in, and then we're going to machine it. Here we are, tool in, use it as a tool. Now we go to the lathe and we machine this. Bust. We need to put a seal in here in order to find the height of the machining, yada, yada, yada. I'll show you in a minute. Once we get to a point, we can check the height to where it should be. So now we go into the machining. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is I'm going to show you what it looks like when you just machine it. Okay, so here is what it looks like when you just machine it and try to polish it. And as I said, you could polish this until you're blue in the face.
Look at that camera over there.
Polish it until you're blue in the face and your seal will wear out. Why? I cannot. Well, yes, I know. The cast is too porous to handle what we have to do. So we need a real fine metal. In this case, it's called centre metal ring. That we machine the impeller for and then glue it in with JB Weld and finish machining and polishing it. And again, you'll have to use your own tooling. Over the years, I made a tool so I don't have to measure. I just machine it and I'm done. So here we machined the groove, as you can see, for the mating ring. It's not the smoothest one in the world, but that's okay. We're going to use JB anyway. So now we're going to find a mating ring. Okay, so here we machined the groove in the impeller. Here's the mating ring that eventually we're going to JB weld it in there. We're going to machine this to a perfect 90 on the axe and finish polishing it. So now the first thing to do is find your height, which in this case with this type of impeller is a little more difficult, but it can be done. Especially where you have a sample. And again, I boo-booed, I didn't measure before I took it apart. But that's happened when you get old. You don't always get smarter. Just a touch more. And I'm sure you'll want to know, how do I know how much? Well, I don't. You just kind of know over the years on how much to take off. Hey, give me in here. Hold that pump up like that. I gotta go more.
A lot more.
Hmm?
A lot more.
Yeah.
Calipers aren't working?
No. I only have two hands.
Looks pretty close.
You know, that's my biggest problem. I don't have enough hands.
Of course, you're going to shave a little off the centered ring, right?
Very little. But I can go a lot if needed. Okay, hang on. Hold it up again. Because I measured without...
gasket.
With the gasket, so almost 8 millimeter. Yeah, I got to go a little deeper. But
when we install it, we can't go that deep as we're holding it by hand. You have to leave at least 50 thousandths before it bottoms out.
Okay. So you got about 50 thousandths to cut off.
We got to go about 50 thousandths because, you know, this is bottomed out.
Right.
And we want to say about 50 thousandths before that. So, we'll take another 50 off.
That ring sure fits in there good.
Yeah. Okay, we'll try it again. And a half, because so what I'll end up doing is take some of this off.
Right.
So now we're going to JB.
That's good to the last drop.
Before, while this is drying, why don't we look for a bearing and make one?
Okay.
Then after lunch we can go to work.
Whatever. You the pump man. Yep. You can't just buy a bearing for that? You gotta make one?
Yes, I can buy them.
Ah.
Okay.
But.
I would need 10 more shelves to put the different sizes of bearings on there.
So, show us how you make one.
So, we buy a universal bearing.
Yeah.
To where we cut them to length for the pumps that we're working on. For us, it's more beneficial.
So, it's a bearing on a shaft?
Like that.
Okay.
But it's longer.
Yeah.
So, I'll be back in a minute.
Okay. We are rolling.
Tell me what you're going to try to do.
You'll see in just a second.
Okay.
No, I won't tell you.
All right. That's fine.
See, in this one, I get to bug you throughout.
So I'll...
This is still on. It's been on for what? 2 weeks now?
I didn't do it.
That end goes down through. Oh, are you going up from the bottom, are you?
Oh, dipstick. No wonder. It would help if I put it on a tube.
He did say something about putting it on a tube, didn't he? No, it's not. Okay.
That'll work. I'll even turn the audio off. I remember how to do that.
You're on.
Wait!
I'm waiting. I'm waiting. Are we ready?
You're rolling.
Thank you. You pulling my trick today?
We're not recording.
How come?
Because you're searching for parts.
Where? The other day, I saw a bucket full of them.